Enjoy the story by taking control of our tormented main. Change various settings. Enjoy the story by taking control of our tormented main character. Enjoy difficult challenges. There are a limited number of items you can use in the puzzle. Enjoy the story by taking control of our tormented main character and guiding him to freedom. Enjoy the story by taking control of our tormented main character and guiding him. Enjoy the story by taking control of our tormented main character and guiding him to freedom. Continue the start from the beginning. Simple nightmares will haunt our protagonist. Choose this if you'd like to play at a relaxed pace. Average nightmares will haunt our protagonist. Choose this if you'd enjoy a bit of a challenge. Frightening nightmares will haunt our protagonist. Choose this if you wish to hone your skills. Peaceful nightmares will haunt our protagonist. Choose this if you never want to die. Simple nightmares will haunt our protagonist. Choose this if you'd like to play at a relaxed pace. In this mode, all blocks will be the usual size, recommended for those looking for traditional gameplay. In this mode, unusually shaped blocks will appear in the puzzles, recommended for those looking for a fresh experience. Very well. Please enjoy the world of Catherine full body with vigor.
Thank you. Full-bodied wine is the best. Oh, dear. When the night sky fills with glamour, a lovely story awaits you. Good evening. Welcome to the Golden Playhouse special feature. Do I see some new faces? Once again, your guide for the night is me, the Midnight Venus, Trisha. Have you heard about this scary rumor? They say if you fall in a dream and don't wake up before you land, you die in real life. Tonight's story is Catherine Fullbody, the second coming of an unconventional romantic horror. A man with a certain curse has a terrifying and dramatic week. Oh, does that sound familiar? Well, like I said, this is Catherine, but with a fuller body. It's aged nicely, with a sensual flavor, not unlike a fine wine. Our hero in this story is Vincent Brooks, age 32. He is an earnest and kind man. But one day we begin to see him have terrifying nightmares. Amidst the storm of temptations around him, he has another chance encounter. And an awfully cute one at that. But doesn't this seem a little convenient? Oh my, sounds like a recipe for disaster. Will Vincent be able to overcome the massive blocks in his life? Perhaps he'll take a road less traveled. His outcome depends on you, viewers. Sorry to keep you waiting. Raise the curtains. It's time to savor the marriage of pleasure and pain. Now enjoy the show until we meet again.
Life will kick you back. Oh, shit! Whoa. What the hell is this place?
Save your breath and start climbing. If you fall, you're dead.
I'll die? You fucking serious?
Edge.
All right, I got it. All right, I got it.
Edge.
All right, I got it. I got it.
Edge. Edge. Edge.
All right, I got it.
Stuck, it may be best to try and undo your moves.
Edge.
Where is this? What is this ringing?
If we both make it out of here alive, we'll meet again.
Hey, wait a sec!
Get out through here.
About to begin. I'll be sure to prepare something extra special for you behind the next door. Let's meet again tomorrow night. I look forward to it.
Hello? I'll be in today's code review meeting. Really? No, I'm just a little under the weather. No, no, it's okay. I'll be right there. Yeah. Sorry.
Hey, where'd you go? Snap out of it! Were you even listening?
Sure.
You know, you've been a little out of it lately. Is everything all right? You've been spacing out left and right.
Oh, sorry. I had to work early this morning.
So, are you getting anything extra for this?
For what?
For all this overtime you're doing.
Oh, not this time.
This time? Do you usually get overtime pay?
Well, no, but...
So you don't get anything? Here, two sugars.
Hey, Catherine. Have you ever had a dream where you died?
You mean, like, where you're in danger?
No. No, where you actually die. You're being killed or something.
No. I usually do the killing in my dreams.
Huh? Yeah, that sounds like you.
What's that supposed to mean? Hey, how many years have we been together?
Huh? So long, I can't remember. How many years?
I'm asking you. It's just, my mother's been calling me up and asking how we're doing.
Oh.
She's worried about me. She knows I've got a career that keeps me busy, but...
Yeah.
I mean, it's easy to keep things like they are now, but...
I don't know. Sometimes easy's best, right? I mean, who knows what'll happen in the future?
I suppose.
And in other news, we have more on the recent string of unexplained deaths that seem to be exclusively involving young men. Cause of death is unknown, and while police are investigating accidental causes, foul play has apparently not been ruled
out. Hey, change it! The match is on!
No! Two beers over here!
Coming!
Catherine keeps telling me how her mother is constantly calling her. She says she's not worried about it, though.
Feather's totally gonna take it, right, Vinny?
And what do you think?
So? Who are you betting on? Come on, pick one!
Are you kidding? Women's wrestling? What I know.
The fight hasn't officially started, but this battle's already begun.
Sounds to me like she finally wants you to tie the knot.
You think so too?
What else could it mean? I've known you since we were kids, but wow, you. Married, huh?
Hey, nothing's set in stone yet.
What, you don't want to marry your girlfriend?
It's not that. I love her, but I don't think we need to run out and get married. You know, it's like we're comfortable where we are.
Are you?
Yeah, that's what she said. Her job's always most important to her. I mean, you know she's always been the ambitious type, right?
It doesn't mean she'll always be like that.
That's not what I mean. Besides... You're single, too.
Hey, I'm still looking for my soulmate. I'm not like you. I've already told my girl that I'm not interested in marrying her.
What if you never meet your soulmate?
Then I'll never get married. So what?
That sounds just like you, Chief.
Oh, how'd the interview go?
The boss seems like a really nice person. He said I could work here starting tomorrow.
So everything's cool with you now?
Mm-hmm. Way better.
Hey, did old boss make any weird moves?
Hey, Rin, come here!
I'll see you later.
Anyway, did you hear about Paul? He's dead.
Paul? Wait, that Paul? He's dead?
Yeah, I heard he just got divorced, but he looked healthy. It's a complete shock.
What happened to him? An accident?
I don't know. Apparently his mother just found him dead in his room this morning.
This morning? Wait, you mean...
Yeah, the mystery death on the news? That was him.
Holy shit, no way!
Maybe Will will wind up dead tomorrow too.
Shut the hell up.
Man, I hate the news. They're always trying to push their agenda for ratings.
Toby, you are really easy to mess with.
Well, speaking of crazy stuff this morning, I pissed the bed for the first time since grade school.
What? Oh, that's messed up, man.
I had a really scary dream, but I don't remember what it was about.
Oh, man. How old are you?
32.
I know that.
You know, I don't think I need to hear this.
Shut up. I was really fucking scared, all right? Whoa, where are you guys going? Stick around. I don't want to go home just yet.
So? Why don't you have Catherine meet you here?
No, I just saw her today. Besides, she'd get mad at me if I told her.
Ah, jeez. What does she see in this poor fool? Sorry, but I gotta be in early tomorrow. Don't drink too much, okay?
All right. Take care, Vince. See you later.
See ya. So, she managed to get the job, huh?
Of course. I can't just abandon someone with amnesia, especially when they seem like such a good kid. And like Johnny said, there's this innocent cluelessness to Rin that, I just can't help caring about. Not to mention the whole stalker thing. Who would do that, and why?
Seems like even she doesn't know.
Now, how could that be? You should find out.
Everything okay now?
Yeah, I think so. I wanted to say thanks. Not just for saving me, but also for finding me a job and a place to stay. I was so scared. I couldn't remember anything. I'm so glad I met someone as nice as you, Vin.
It's nothing, really. Anyone would have done the same.
Still, you saved me, Vincent. I start working here tomorrow, so I'll do my best to show you my appreciation.
Got a mail.
From time to time, you'll receive texts at the bar. You can respond to some of them. Give it a try.
Thank you.
certain words and actions change Vincent's inner ideas, a meter will be shown. Vincent's words and actions will affect the story. Remember it.
Hey, how many years have we been together?
Marriage, huh? Figured this would happen eventually, but just changed jobs. I don't want to give her trouble. Bringing up her parents out of the blue? It's not like her.
You got a mail.
I don't feel like going home today. Oh, funny. It's Catherine.
Hello, Vincent. It's me.
Yeah, what's up?
I wanted to apologize for cutting our meeting short this morning.
You had to meet with a friend, right?
Yeah. Oh, it was a woman, just so you know. I think you knew her in high school?
It's okay. What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. You have to go to work early tomorrow, right? Don't stay out too late. Good night.
It's late.
Would you like to save your progress?
Excuse me.
Mind if I sit here?
Some new faces. That poor lost soul is particularly intriguing. You'll find there are many lost sheep in the prison of despair.
Where am I? Last night's dream? Again? What the hell? I was at the bar and this girl came in and then... Damn, I can't remember. What's going on? Alright.
You the new guy from last night?
Voice. You're that guy from yesterday.
Listen, watch out for the cracked blocks. They'll break after you step on them.
Really? Got it.
If you're stuck, it may be best to try and undo your moves.
Undo. Edge.
Pretty far. Good job. I'll see you at the landing. Everybody else is there, too.
Who's everyone? Hey, hey, wait a sec.
Like you survived.
Who are you? A sheep?
Do I look like a sheep? You're the sheep. Everybody here's a sheep but me.
I don't recognize that voice. Who are you? Where the hell is this place?
Wish I knew. One thing's for certain, though. If we don't run, we're going to be killed.
Killed?
If you see this place once, it's all over. You'll keep coming back every night.
Every night? You're kidding me.
We all have the same fate here. If you don't want to die, you've got to climb.
So if I climb, I'll be saved?
There's no guarantee. But take a look at that. See that bell? It's like a church or something.
A church?
If we can reach the top, there may be a way to escape.
So there is a way.
Like I said, there's no guarantee. But we've got to believe. It keeps us sane. Those who panic die first.
Quit with all the dying stuff. I'll do whatever you say. Just help me.
Look, from here on out, I'm afraid you're on your own. I'm going now.
No, wait.
You hurry too.
Hey! Kid, be serious.
You can save in the notebook and talk with other sheep on the landings. Go on, talk to them. When the icon is pink, you can talk to them. It grays out once they have nothing more to say.
Ren. We're discussing techniques. They're the key to survival. Maybe this will be useful. You want me to teach you the technique I found?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. Remember, this is Todd's technique.
Allow me to explain the pyramid. Pull out the same number of blocks as the number of steps you mean to climb up. You'll have the support you need to reach higher and higher, like a pyramid. Remember this basic technique.
What'd you think? Nice.
I think that might be tough by itself. Consider using this one, too.
Allow me to explain the slider. Pull out two blocks vertically, then slide the bottom one over. Remember this basic action, which utilizes the properties of edges. Since edges connect, you can make a stairway, even in tight spots.
Oh, you're a genius. How was that? Bet you didn't know.
Well...
Anyway, what I want to say is this. If you're relying on luck to keep you alive, it's all over.
I know. My reporter's instincts are telling me this dangerous form of free climbing has some techniques hidden within it.
There are many techniques to discover. I guess the key is to find as many as we can.
All right. If you find anything, you tell me, okay?
I don't want to die!
Just calm down.
Are you saying that to try to bring my guard down?
I'm not falling for that. Everyone's just out to save some asshole pushed me too. Next time, gotta start shoving or I'll die.
Maybe this will be useful.
Where am I? What's with all these damn sheep?
That's all I want to know. Can you tell me anything?
They told me to go up. What's up there? Give me a break.
Everyone's just out to save themselves.
I'll have to use that next time.
What is this place? Why was I taken here?
Same here. Wish I knew.
What are those cages? Why are there sheep in them? I've had it. Get me out of here!
Hey, you okay? Keep it together, man.
You're quite virtuous, however, to be concerned about someone other than yourself, given our present circumstances. I'm going to reward you with an oil field.
An oil field?
Ah, my usual habit.
Everyone dies eventually. Dying sooner at least saves you some pain, right?
Hurry up. Die if we stay here.
There's someone in there, right?
Why don't you take a seat?
Oh, man.
Hey, long time no see. Or rather, nice to see you here. And welcome to the confessional.
Who are you?
This is the world of nightmares. I guess you could call me its supervisor. I sense a force of change rising up. What exactly happened in the other world? I guess it doesn't matter. You lambs are all destined to die here anyway.
What? Don't be ridiculous.
But before I kill you, I want to determine the value of your life. So you'll have to answer some questions.
Question 1. What expectations do you have for your significant other? Pull the rope with the answer that best matches your true feelings.
that's your choice. I guess everybody's different.
Hey, who are you? Are you doing all this?
I told you. I'm just the supervisor. Someone else brought you here. It's someone you know. You never know what people are actually thinking. To learn the truth, you must survive. Then you can think about what's going on here. Let's head to the next trial.
Damn it, what is going on? There's still more?
Commencing Area 2. Are you ready?
Alright, I got it. Alright.
Are you getting the hang of this?
How the fuck am I supposed to get the hang of this? Hey, don't run off ahead! Help me!
Sorry, man, but I'm not going to die helping you. I've got to climb, too.
Yes. All right, I got it.
Find a way forward. You may wish to undo and try a new strategy.
Edge.
I've seen others here and there. The fighting's gonna start getting fierce. This is a dog-eat-dog world. There's no time for courtesy. Anyway, no matter what pops up, stay calm.
What the hell is this plate?
I don't know. I wish I did.
Alright, I got it. Alright. Alright, I got it. Alright, I got it. How's this?
Edge.
If you're stuck,
right.
It's
all right,
be
I got
best
it.
To...
I made it!
Here I go!
It's you. Looks like you're still alive.
Is that you? You're safe too.
Barely. Still. How many people died trying to come here?
People? I don't...
Listen. Here, you see everybody else as sheep. But all these sheep, they're really human.
There's got to be some reason why we were all brought here.
What reason could there be? Why do we have to suffer like this?
Who knows? But I do have an idea.
An idea?
But stop the speculation. It's just going to confuse us more. You should think of what to do next. I'm hearing rumors of something big coming soon. You be careful now.
Something big?
Still, you're really getting the hang of things. There's nothing more I can teach you.
That can't be true. Come on, you gotta have something you can tell me.
If we're lucky, we'll meet again.
Hey, wait! Great.
At the landings, you can learn tips on how to climb. Moving blocks around mindlessly won't work. Try to pick up some new techniques will be written down by the other sheep.